The Situation Room with Will Blitzer, weekday afternoons at 4 Eastern on CNN.
The accusation that's being made, and you've heard this many times, by those who are protesting, is that President Morsy, he was democratically elected. He got just more than 51% of the vote, which is enough to get him elected president of Egypt, the first election in Egypt ever, shall we say. But he's beginning to act like Mubarak, like a dictator. Yeah.
Well, I think these are unaccepted accusations or unaccepted statements, because he is insisting on carrying on with the democratic process. Actually, he is devolving his powers. He is returning to the people. So what is undemocratic in returning to the people, to the will of the people, to express their liberal views towards how they want to see the future of Egypt?
The other concern that a lot of the protesters are, especially the liberal ones, are saying is you want Sharia law imposed in Egypt. Do you?
Actually, the liberals, the seculars, and all those who are were in the Constituent Assembly and in other document accepted the second article of Sharia. So there's no dispute about Sharia issue.
So will Sharia law be imposed in Egypt?
Well, Sharia, as we understand it, is the basic values of the 25th revolution. It's dignity, it's justice, it's freedom. How to implement this within the country, this is something the parliament will decide.
Well, what will that mean for Egyptian women?
Well, Egyptian women has all the right to be empowered to make their own choices. This is how we see a democratic state
will
is going
they have
forward
equal rights
and
as
how
men?
Sharia is. Well, yes, they do have now in Egypt equal rights as men, but we have to identify the traditions and the awareness of these rights. Our role is to empower women to have better choices and let them make their own choices.
Because when we think of Sharia law, we think of Saudi Arabia. Is that what you want in Egypt?
I think Egypt is different from Saudi Arabia and different from other countries.
Each Will women country, have to wear the veil?
Well, have to. It's a woman's choice. If they want to wear the veil, it is the right to
what
do
if
it.
They don't want to?
It is the right to do it.
So that won't change?
Nobody will impose anything on anybody as long as it is within the framework of the law.